wonderful to have your company this Wednesday morning. We've got breaking news at 8. A man has been charged with 3 counts of murder after that horror boarding house fire in Sydney's inner west. Gabrielle Boyle is at the scene in Newtown. Gabby, what more do we know at this stage?
Ali, I can confirm that the 45-year-old man who has been charged with murder is a former resident of this boarding house. It was at 7:40 last night that he walked into Surry Hills Police Station in the city and handed himself in to police. He spoke to detectives for some time and has subsequently been charged with murder. Later on this morning, he'll appear before Central Local Court to face those charges, and that's also in Sydney's CBD. This is an absolutely awful crime. 3 people are dead, a 4th man is missing, and 2 remain in hospital. One of those men is in his 80s. He's in a critical condition after jumping for his life from those flames. He broke both ankles during that jump and had a heart attack afterwards in hospital due to the stress. It was an awful, awful crime, and it has left this community reeling. Certainly here in the street, it is still cordoned off, and now that the sun is up, we've once again got a large number of detectives back on the scene. They'll once again trawling through the remainder of that boarding house property. The worry, however, is that that second story could still collapse. So it's a very difficult, tedious and time-consuming operation. They also need to speak to a large number of residents in this area, door-knocking house by house to make sure they're able to get all of the details in this case. So just reiterating, a 45-year-old former resident of this boarding house has been charged with murder, Ali.
Just terrible. Thanks, Gabby.
New South Wales police all over that one. Also breaking this hour, a man has been charged after an alleged road rage attack outside a Melbourne school. A warning, these exclusive pictures are confronting. Take a look. A normal school pickup and then this. A shirtless man forcing a pole through a ute window as children cower in the back seat. The stake becomes stuck. Students begin to flee, and then the punches fly. The man managing to pry open the door before the tables turn. The fight spilling into the middle of the street and stopping oncoming traffic. Then the shirtless man begins to retreat, but the brawl is far from over. Terrified children and parents watched it all unfold. And soon enough, the police were there, putting the shirtless man in handcuffs. Elizabeth Moss is at Melton Secondary College. Elizabeth, the man facing court today?
He is, Carl. He's been charged with multiple offences, including reckless conduct, endangering life, affray and assault with a weapon. He'll be remanded, so he'll stay in custody until his court appearance this morning. I have spoken with a witness this morning who was here during that school pickup time. They claim that actually there's more to this story. The Nissan Navara driver actually mounted the curb at some points. She claims that the Nissan Navara driver tried to run this man over before that very confronting vision that we saw. Whatever unfolded here, the court will get to the bottom of this, a very terrifying and confronting situation for those children.
I don't know what we do. I had a kid in my car, they started yelling. I'm still panicked. I can see my body is shivering.
Carl, thankfully, no one was seriously injured in the incident.
Awful for the kids to watch, wasn't it? Elizabeth, thank you.
Heavy sanctions could soon hit China after the US flagged to its allies that Beijing was willing to supply military equipment to Russia. The White House says if China decides to help with the assault on Ukraine, it would result in serious consequences, likely in the form of economic sanctions. Australia has indicated it would follow suit in applying similar punishments. Sydney's transport network is in for more disruptions and possible shutdowns as the union goes up against the state government. Take a listen to this.
The public in New South Wales need an apology and they need a fare free day.
If you promise not to strike for another year, I'll give fare free Fridays for a full year.
The union movement will not work in good faith with this government.
It's on. Today, correspondent Lara Bella is on a train to Penrith. Lara, good morning. How's it looking?
Yeah, on the express line to Penrith this morning, at this stage, Alex, it looks like it's pretty smooth sailing for most commuters, but that certainly wasn't the case yesterday. We know that any minor disruption on our rail network here in Sydney has major implications for those commuters. We saw that yesterday once again play out on the North Shore line. If you take a look at some of these pictures, you can see all of those passengers crammed in like sardines. And then, of course, Alex, just a few weeks ago, we had our entire rail network shut down as a result of this trading of barbs that is continuing between both the union and also the transport minister. Now, in the meantime, Alex, we know that the union is still not happy with the negotiations that it's been having with the state government. They're still fighting for better pay, better safety conditions. And at this stage, they are still threatening more industrial action every Friday unless the state government apologises and also offers to waive fares for commuters every Friday until June. But in the meantime, Alex, you've then got the minister accusing the union of terrorist-like behaviour. We know that both parties are set to come to talks once again this Thursday. We will wait to see what the outcome is of those key talks. But at this stage, Alex, I really don't think a single commuter on this line this morning could care less about having their fares waived on a Friday. They really just want to get to their destination on time and, of course, safely.
Has to be sorted. Hear, hear. It has to be sorted soon. Lara, thanks so much. Low wages and huge workloads are fueling an exodus from teaching, leaving schools short-staffed. That is according to the Teachers Union. We are joined by Angelo Gavrilados from the New South Wales Teachers Federation in Sydney. Angelo, good morning to you. Thanks for being with us. How dire is this situation at the moment?
Well, it's a crisis, Alex. Literally every single day, hundreds upon hundreds of classes are being interrupted. Classes are split, they're merged, or students are minimally supervised in playgrounds. That's impacting the education wellbeing of thousands and thousands of students every single day.
There are suggestions of a shortage of 1,700 educators over 3 years. Is that right?
Well, that's an understatement. In the latest publicly available data that was tabled in the New South Wales Parliament shows that the vacancies we've got this year alone are 2,383. And what's most disturbing is with the dramatic increase in student enrolments expected over the next 10 to 20 years, we will need a further 11,000 teachers in 10 years' time. We have a crisis, but worse still, we have governments in denial, refusing to act on the evidence.
Okay, Angelo, this is a big problem and it's going to have a big impact on students too. You tweeted this morning, the sooner the government stops with the denial, spin, gimmickry and cover-up, the better we will be. The cause of the teacher shortage is uncompetitive salaries and unsustainable workloads, and they know it. If you know the cause, you know the solution. So I ask you, Angelo, what is the solution here?
Well, the solution is addressing the uncompetitive salaries and the unsustainable workloads. That answer has been provided to the government time and time again. We now have state government commissioned reports, we have federal government commissioned reports, all of which point in the same direction. It's the uncompetitive salaries and unsustainable workloads which is resulting in the shortage, which will get worse. As I've said, if you know the cause of the problem, you know the solution. They've got to get on and fix it and stop the denial, stop the spin, stop the gimmickry and stop the cover-up.
If they don't come to the table, will you go on strike?
Well, we suspended industrial action this term. We suspended industrial action this term, giving the Premier the opportunity to sit down with us to address and resolve these issues. The Premier has failed. The Premier has failed to embrace this opportunity and in doing so has failed kids, their parents and teachers. We're left with no other option but to recommit to the full range of strategies available to us from next term.
OK, not ruling that out. Angelo Gavrilados, thank you so much for your time this morning.